The gastroenteritis outbreak in Baguio City now officially contained. That's according to Health Undersecretary Eric Tayag. He says around 3,000 cases were detected in the city. He adds water that tested positive for fecal coliform was traced to a water delivery station. The Baguio City Health Office was also able to isolate the norovirus and sapovirus, which are both pathogens responsible for diarrhea.
Pag fecal coliform po, ibig sabihin nun ay galing sa isang tao na may sakit, kaya po maaring ito ang naging dahilan po ng naturang outbreak sa Baguio City. Ito mga nag-positive po ay doon sa mga nagdi-deliver po ng tubig. Kaya dahil sa mabilis na aksyon ni Mayor Benji Magalong at ng Department of Health po, at ito po ay na-contain kaagad.
Water districts across the country will be implementing water conservation measures to prepare for the impact of the El Nino phenomenon. The Local Water Utilities Administration says water districts were instructed to minimize the wastage of water to below 20%. The agency is also strengthening its information campaign on water conservation and ensuring local units have a sufficient water supply inventory.
Meron po tayong tinatawag natin na water conservation measures. At ang gusto nating mangyari dito ay magkaroon pa tayo ng mas maraming mga proyekto na gawin para magkaroon po ng mga infrastructure projects in response to the El Nino, na bigyan natin ng mas maraming tugon pa ito.
Philippine Home Development Fund Pag-ibig doubling its member contribution starting next month. According to its CEO, Marilyn Acosta, the mandatory contributions will be raised to 200 pesos per month from the current 100 pesos. Acosta says the contribution hike will allow Pag-ibig to raise around 38 billion pesos annually in additional revenue. This will allow the fund to maintain the lowest interest rates for its housing loans at 6% per annum.
Philippine Agriculture Chief Francisco Tu Laurel unveils his three-year plan to boost the country's agricultural productivity and lower food costs. Laurel plans to modernize the sector to ensure that farmers and fisherfolk get the value for their produce and to keep prices affordable. He adds the DA plans to establish more irrigation infrastructure and build more post-harvest facilities. Laurel also says he will appoint an assistant secretary for logistics to optimize costs for all stakeholders involved.
Besides that, we have a big digitalization move in order to get more accurate production data for our production. As you know, we need real production data in order to be able to manage the food supply of the country effectively.
A Philippine historian believes it is time to revise the Philippine Constitution. Manolo Quezon compared the charter to an old computer operating system that needs to be updated. He says it would be in the interest of everyone to see the economy revitalized, which can be achieved with a constitutional review.
There's never a good time, but there's also the government running out of time. You have this situation, a practical situation. There's going to be a midterm in 2025. And if there's no money, there's not much of a game plan for anyone, except if they're going to have to spend their own personal money. Mm-hmm. And that's something every politician is allergic to.
Quezon adds the Senate's willingness to come to the table may spell success for the push for charter change.
It's very hard for people to come to a consensus, but if there's a consensus that exists, it's among businessmen and the people who listen to businessmen, and it involves the economic provisions. What's changed is the nature of the mandate that President Marcos got. It means something when you get the first majority in almost 50 years. The question is, what do you do with that something?
House leaders reject allegations the ongoing People's Initiative is being driven by the House Speaker and the lower house. House Deputy Majority Leader for Communication, Congressman Erwin Tulfo, says there were no instructions to push for the two chambers of Congress to vote jointly in constitutional amendments. The statements come amid allegations lawmakers were being offered 20 million pesos each to deliver the needed signatures for a People's Initiative.
Well, they were saying they're accusing it's Speaker Romualdez doing this and that. May mga nagsasalita naman na it wasn't the Speaker actually who initiated this. Wherever they got that information, I don't know. Siguro sinisiraan lang.
Tensions further deepening in the Korean Peninsula. Pyongyang's leader Kim Jong-un calls for a constitutional change to identify Seoul as the North's primary foe. He spoke Monday at the nation's rubber stamp parliament. Kim reiterated his earlier comment that reunification with the South is no longer possible. He also wants the country's charter amendment to identify the North as separate from the South. Responding, South Korean President Yoon Suk-yeol described Kim's move as anti-national and ahistorical. Yoon also said Pyongyang's missile tests were a political provocation.